I'm actually feeling kind of nervous. I'm not sure why. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Summer Meyers. I'm a homeschool mom to 5 kids. And on this channel, we talk all things homeschool. So if that is something you are interested in, hit that subscribe button. Today we are talking about books. I think I sat on my camera lens.
Oh gosh. Oh my gosh, that's so bad for your camera. Don't ever do that, guys.
I think I got it. It was like a piece of lint or something. Where was I? Today I want to talk to you about fall books. Now, some of these books are books that I have chosen from the library. Some of them are, it's pretty evenly split, are books that I actually own and loved and my kids have loved and grown up with. And I wanted to share that with you today. Do you guys want to do library books first or books I own first? I guess books I own first, right? Okay, these books are well loved, guys. Well loved. This is called Possum Come A-Knocking. Possum Come A-Knocking is the most adorable book. And this is a book that I grew up with when I was a child. It was a book that my mother loved reading to me. She is from Virginia and she can pull out the accent when she's hot and bothered. So this has a story of a sweet little family who are doing family things around in the evening, and this possum comes and he's knocking on the door and it interrupts their evening. And they're all, who's at the door? It's kind of late. What y'all doing? Who's at the door? Go open the door and see who it is. And the little girl knows it's a possum. And she says, guys, it's a possum. There's a possum at the door and he's knocking. But it's such a funny and cute book to read. This is also one of my favorite read alouds to do for preschoolers because it captures their attention. It's got good rhythm, good poetic rhythm, and it's engaging and fun. Just really, really cute story. Check it out. I think all homeschoolers own this book. I think. Maybe not. The Oxcart Man. I think this is one of those books that when you do a farming unit, you end up borrowing or getting the Oxcart Man. Anyway, it's a story about a farmer and the things that they prepare during the year of getting ready for harvest and then taking it to market and selling it and then preparing for winter and then what they do during the winter time until spring arrives. So this is more of a year-round fall season sort of thing, but it begins in the fall with harvest and market. And it's a really cute story, especially if you're doing some kind of a farming unit, some kind of a gardening unit, something about harvesting in the fall. Really cute story. Okay, this is showing my roots. This is The Coat of Many Colors by Dolly Parton. Dolly Parton, man, is like fire. I mean, I love Dolly Parton. I mean, look at this picture that they have her on the back. This is a story of her childhood. And when I read this, I can hear her voice in my head. And it's the story of her mama making her a patchwork quilt coat and what it meant to her. And I love the family values in it. I love this idea of, you know, it doesn't matter where you come from. What matters is the love that you found in your home and the love of your mother and, you know, the success that you gain from that. And I love the story of it and it makes me cry. Who doesn't love a good children's book that makes you cry? Anyway, such a sweet story. I have lost the book cover for this, but this is If You Give a Moose a Muffin. I like this and I consider this fall because it has moose and muffins and sweaters and buttons. I mean, I think we're all familiar with If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. These books are so much fun and I love getting these out for fall and I love talking about the seasons and the different animals that come with fall. I guess moose are year round. I mean, they don't just, you know, go away. So I apologize for the binding. This is well loved in my home. The Rough Faced Girl by Rafi Martin. I should be saying their names, I'm sorry. It's a Cinderella story where she is always tending to the fire and her skin becomes rough. And she's got two evil stepsisters and they're gonna go marry the invisible being who is this wealthy, powerful chief in their tribe. It's all about inner beauty. And I think the thing is with books like inner beauty, it's all about girls' inner beauty. I get that. Girls need to know that beauty is on the inside, but I think very rarely do we talk to little boys about their inner power and inner beauty, because it's talking to them about inner beauty, I mean, it's like, you're beautiful on the inside to a little boy, I don't know. The story is also about how she sees more to this powerful chief than just what's on the outside. So the evil stepsisters want to marry this this really rich, powerful guy because he's rich and powerful. But she sees him everywhere and she knows him and knows his heart. And for that reason, she is chosen, not just because of her inner beauty, but because she sees it in him as well. And I think that's a message that should be shared more often. The next book is kind of a, it's like phasing into winter. So this is a fall book for us, but I can see where this would kind of blur the lines. It's called Sleep, Big Bear, Sleep. I love this for read alouds for my preschoolers. I love the rhythm. I love the words that are used and I love the images. And it's this big bear who's going around town and he's mishearing Old Man Winter. Old Man Winter is telling him, I'm coming, you need to go get ready for bed. And Big Bear just wanders around and mishears him. He's like, I have to go ride a Jeep. I have to go sweep the back porch. I have to, you know, like he's doing all these chores that he doesn't necessarily need to do. He needs to go and prepare for winter hibernation. So this is such a cute story. I love the pictures and I love reading this aloud. This is a fun read aloud. So those are the books that I actually own. These are the books that I have borrowed from the library. And this one I have borrowed pretty much every fall for the last 2 years. So this is called The Scarecrow and it's about a scarecrow. He's all alone. He's out scaring crows and none of the animals go and talk to him until a little black crow falls and he bends down and he picks him up and saves him and they become friends. And it's just a story of that friendship, also the passing of seasons, and just, it's really sweet, sweet fall story. Now, Owl Sees Owl has beautiful illustrations. This is a really excellent early preschool book. Also early reader. I mean, this would be really good for somebody who's trying to build their confidence in reading. And it's just supposed to invoke images of warmth and the cool fall night. And I love how beautiful it is. I think usually we talk about fall as oranges and yellows and kind of vibrant fall fire colors. And this one's all about the dark blues and the whisper of night. And I love that. All right, this one I had not seen. It's called Tidy. It's really cute. It's about a badger who goes and he's just obsessed with keeping things clean and picked up. And fall comes and all of a sudden there's leaves all over the ground. And he's like, it's not clean and tidy anymore. And he like tidies everything up and puts concrete down. And then it's not a forest anymore. And he's really, really sad. And so it's just the story of the badger trying to grapple with keeping things tidy and fall cleaning. And then realizing that it's okay and that there's natural beauty there. Maybe it's not quite, it's not a super deep book, but it's really cute and fun. And I love the little animals that are in there. And I like this idea of them keeping the forest tidy. This is Elmore. And Elmore is a very sweet, lonely porcupine. He wants to make friends and he puts a sign up and says, I'm looking for a friend, and nobody goes because they're like, he's kind of pokey. They don't want to get too close. And instead what he does is he talks to his grandfather, who makes him feel better about himself and who he is. And then he goes back and tries again. And he takes his porcupine quills and makes little presents out of them and gives them to the forest folk, who are immensely grateful and realize what a great person, great porcupine he is. And I really liked the action that he takes. He's not passive. He's not passive in his woe. And I found that interesting in a children's book. Anyway, it's really cute, really sweet, fun fall book. Fletcher and the Falling Leaves. I might get this one. It's so cute. I hadn't read this one before. It's a fox one. He is in love with this tree and he loves how the colors are changing, but then they start to fall down and he kind of freaks out and he is worried about his friend, the tree, and he wants the tree to keep the leaves and he's his concern. And I think this was a good way of, I've never met a child who's like overly concerned about fall. I'm sure they're out there. But just talking about the changing of seasons and what that means and the changing of time, just really cute. And I loved how it worked out in the end. This is In November. This book by Cynthia Ryland. She has done several books that I do actually own. First of all, it has all kinds of animals and what they are doing and getting ready for winter, kind of like The Sleep Big Bear, but it's more gentle and soft and cozy, and it just invokes these warm nostalgic feelings of fall at least for me. And I love the pictures in it. And we borrow this every year. I'm probably going to need to go ahead and buy it. This is such a fabulous, fabulous read for the fall. All right, guys, that is it for me today. Those are the fall books that we are reading right now, but we're going to go through them. So if you guys have a favorite fall book, let me know down in the comments so we can check those out. I would really love to hear what you guys like to read for the fall. Take it easy, everybody. Bye.